everyone. Welcome back to Cage Freed, where we have a fancy intro, but not fancy videos. It's just how I roll. All right, today I'm going to talk to you guys about a recent endurance race I did, endurance gravel race. I've done it a couple times in the past, and this year I had a goal to double my distance. So the race is called the Day Across Minnesota, or the Dam for short. It's 242 miles from the border of Minnesota, Gary, South Dakota, to Hager City, Wisconsin, and it's a 24-hour race. So the goal is you cross from South Dakota to Hager City, Wisconsin in 24 hours or less. And this year they included an option for the double dam. So that meant you went to Wisconsin and back. I think the total of that was about 495 miles in 48 hours or less. And I made my attempt at that this year. I did do the single dam again, 242 miles to Wisconsin. However, I was not physically prepared this year to do the double dam. In terms of cycling, I was physically prepared. However, unfortunately, and this is just how life pans out sometimes, my day job work blew up about a week and a half before. I was working overtime, I was working weekends, and the night before the race, I got about 3 hours of sleep. Because I was also juggling all of this with trying to get ready for the race. I had work done on my bike. I had to set up my tubeless tires again. And there was lots of stuff I had to get taken care of that unfortunately didn't happen. So I did finish the 242, the first half. I had more than 24 hours to get back, and I would have been able to take a little nap. But I realized I was already in a sleep deprivation hole that a couple hours of sleeping wasn't gonna get me out of. I had never felt kind of delirious on that race in the past. I've done it multiple times, remember? And I felt delirious this time when I left in at night. It starts at midnight as well, so it's also counterintuitive to how your body works. And I just realized I wasn't going to be able to recoup the hours I needed for sleep, and there was only a handful of people who ended up turning back for the double dam. And I think part of maturing as an endurance cyclist and cyclist generally is knowing your limits on certain days. You're gonna have life circumstances that don't allow you to do what you want to do. Some days your body's just not up to it. And I thought I would be putting myself more in danger by forcing myself to go do the race and be on gravel roads in the dark where I had the possibility of falling and breaking something and not having anyone nearby. And so I made the best choice for me. The good news is the course is always still there. I can go make another attempt. Sounds like maybe it'll be around next year again. This was supposed to be the last year, but I think it was just the last year with this organizer. I can always go and attempt it again. It's there, it's not going anywhere. And I plan on doing that because I wanted to accomplish this. So, but that's how my race went. But I think people go and do either bike packing or endurance events that perhaps I've never done them before, and you don't know what to pack exactly. And I'm gonna give you a rundown on what I packed for this particular endurance race. And a lot of this would also be with me on longer bike packing tours, but this is what I packed in this particular race with me. So I'm gonna go over it all quickly with you. If you have questions, let me know, or about things that you might want to pack in the future, or questions about why I pack something, let me know. Of course I pack chamois butter because everyone knows you need chamois butter. I only have one of these because one's attached to my camera mount right now for a light, but this is a little external port, phone port. I used a GPX file for this race. They normally don't allow that on this race, it's just cue sheets, and for the first time this year they decided to allow it. I also carried the cue sheets with me as a backup because, as we know, technology will fail when you need it the most. And so I brought two of these with me in the case that my phone routing system died. I just use Ride with GPS. I don't have a bike computer or anything yet at this moment, so I opted for two of these because I wanted to be extra sure. Two lights. I just got this. A friend recommended it to me and I really like it, especially when it comes to backpacking and stuff. The Phoenix light. It has multiple modes. It's actually a flashlight. It's really bright. And the type of battery it uses, I forget. I think my friend said they are the ones used in electric cars. But it holds a charge for a really, really long time, and then they charge really fast. And the flashlight came with two of these, and I have a bike mount for it. But I also like it for bike packing because you always need a flashlight when you camp, and this way it's dual purpose, so I really like that. I have a battery operated rear light. Battery operated just lasts a little longer. I just use rechargeable batteries. I always carry sunblock with me because sunblock, this is a stick that I just use on my face. Multi-tool, this is the Topic 2B 18 multi-tool that I've reviewed previously. If not in here in a video, I did a written review of it, so you can check it out on my blog, cagefreed.bike. But it comes with everything you would need for a tubeless tire puncture, which is what I love about it. And so, yes, I always have this one with me. I carry an extra tube just in case I get a blowout that is not fixable. Tubeless wise, it's a rarity, but I carry a tube with me just in case. Phone cord for charging. I also carry sunblock chapstick with me always because lips have been burnt before. Regular sunblock, and this wasn't actually what I carried with me. I carried a spray can, but I finished it during the tour, so I threw that away. A bike pump, as always. Thing I don't like about this one is it's long, but I love this bike pump. It's a surface bike pump, and the reason why is because it has the flip out pedal and flip out handle, so you can use it like a foot pump. I am not into the mini pumps where it's too tiring, and I'd rather just have something that simulates a foot pump more. So space wise disadvantage, ease of use advantage. I always carry the Voila straps with me because you never know when you need something a strap to fix something. This was actually the light mount I used. It's not gonna fit in there, yeah. So I had this attached to my bike. And then here's my little toolkit. I always carry a tube of tire sealant with me, sands, some chain lube, valve core remover, tire lever, and then I put my batteries in here too. So these are extra batteries for my lights. And so I also did the race non-supported. So they have checkpoints marked. There's, and you can only do 3 checkpoints each way. So they were gas stations. One was a bar. So resupplying with fuel and food and using the bathroom besides in the wild. I always carry this little kit with me too, a patch kit just in case. I always carry a Presta valve converter with me. So if I had a blow and I was near a gas station, I could just use a gas station hose. Quick link, and that's kind of all that's in here. I just have this extra little, I throw extra little pieces in this thing. And that's pretty much it for tools, just the basics. Just ran that. It's okay, I'll fix it. And then for personal stuff, I always carry a toothbrush and toothpaste with me because, yes, it's only 48 hours, but if you know what it's like to ride the first 24 and your teeth are just nasty from eating all day, I will always brush my teeth once because it's gross. I brought these Wilderness wipes with me. If I was gonna take a nap in between, if I had taken a nap in between my legs, I would have wiped my body down. I also brought, and I don't have it out here because it's dirty, but I also brought my camping washcloth. So it's like a microfiber cloth. And I usually just use a water bottle and wipe my body down with that because of course you're really dirty on the gravel race. I always carry some TP with me. And then I made a little first aid kit, so if I had fallen or anything, the tweezers. And I like the tweezers for it to remove small things from my, like, tires too, if you get something in there. Some bandages, some cleaning, and towels and antiseptic, antibiotic ointment. And then I always carry this with me. This is chafing powder gel. It's made by Monistat. Thick thighed girls, you know. This stuff is awesome, and sometimes I use it on my butt, and it helps. Don't judge. If you also ride 242 miles, then you can judge me if you don't need that. But personally, I like it. I love Tailwind Nutrition. I love their electrolyte supplements. I did a review for them a while back and I really like their stuff. I was using Scratch Labs prior to this, but I love this. It doesn't have colors in it. It's very light. They have a Coca-Cola flavor, which reminds me of the Coca-Cola flavored bottle caps, if you remember those. And they have all different flavors. They have ones without a flavor. And I really like them. I overpacked these, but I just wasn't sure how much I would need. So I took a guess, and now I have a better estimate for next time around. And then I carry the extra clothes with me. Everyone's different, but I wanted to have a swap of clothing after my first half because sitting in a nasty, dirty chamois for 48 hours does not sound like a lot of fun to me. So I brought an extra just jersey t-shirt. I don't really wear jerseys. It's just a sports shirt. I brought 2 chamois, extra chamois, because again, I hate sitting in a dirty chamois. Judge me as you may, it's not very much weight. It doesn't bother me. I carry them. And then I brought just some bike shorts or just some regular exercise shorts with me because if I was gonna take a nap, I didn't, and some a pair of underwear. Because if I was gonna take a nap, I didn't wanna sleep in a chamois. So yeah, I brought an extra pair of socks to also swap my socks out. And then I had two pairs of gloves with me because, again, things get gross and nasty, and it's just nice to switch to a fresh pair. Here's my emergency bivy. So this is the bivy I would have just thrown down and taken a nap in. My bike shoes, my helmet, and of course the current COVID essential is a mask. I just carry it with me in my food thing, and then when I go inside someplace, I throw it on. Let's see. A lot of this stuff was in my Topeak front pack. And then I had my Topeak rear seat pack as well. I used that and it worked really well. I'm going to show you also what I used for hydration and how that's set up on my bike, and you can kind of take a look at the setup of my bike right now. Okay, so what I had done for the Double Dam for hydration setup is I had the bottle cages that I talked about before with 1 liter water bottles. And then I actually took this off the other day, but I had another of these bottle cages here on my fork. And let me show you here. And I used Nalgene on the fork here. So I had essentially, this is over a liter. I had more than 3 liters with me because I did it unsupported and it's the summer, it's hot. I knew that I was gonna need a little extra water. And so I just wanted to have 3, and because it's unsupported, I could only make 3 stops. That's part of the race deal. So I wanted to make sure I had more than enough water with me at all times. So that's kind of what I did for the race. All right, so a different day, as you can tell here. I did that video and then I lost some of the footage, so had to reshoot parts of this. So that was kind of all my gear, my hydration setup for the Double Dam ride. Hopefully it was helpful to you in maybe planning some of your own tours or endurance races. And if you have questions, shoot me a question on the comments, or any comments or things that you do. I think it's always good to trade secrets with one another. So excuse the kitty, he's always curious. So thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe and hit the like button. One other thing I should mention before I go is that I haven't had a lot of videos lately. I've just been dealing with, like I said before, some personal things, and also it just hasn't been as busy because, as we all know, there's a supply shortage and shipping issues, so there hasn't really been as much for me to review this year. But I did buy some things on my own that I was very excited about, and I want to review them because I like them. I recommend it. So far, there's some things I can see improvements on, but pretty excited about it. I tested it for the last couple months and excited to give you guys a review. So look for that next week. I'm gonna work on it this week, and I'll get that out to you next week. And I have a couple other things, so I'll be trying to be posting a little more regularly. But again, if you liked this video, subscribe to my channel and also hit like on the video itself, and let's share endurance riding and tour riding supply tips and tricks with each other, because it's always fun to do. All right, thanks for watching.